Hey everyone, Mark here with Miramar College, and today we'll be talking about oxygen administration by non-breather mask. We're going to go through this real quick. Let's talk about the skill. So we're going to verbalize standard precautions, make sure that the scene is safe. That's always number one at the top of your skills. Then we're going to gather the appropriate equipment. We'll talk about that in a moment. You're going to crack the valve on the oxygen tank, ensuring that there's no debris blocking the port. Then you will assemble the regulator to the oxygen tank. Open the oxygen tank valve, check the tank pressure, make sure it's going to be in the range of maybe 1 to 2,000 PSI. That would be ideal. Check for any leaks. Attach the non-rebreather mask to the correct port of the regulator. Turn on the oxygen flow to pre-fill the reservoir bag. Since this is a non-rebreather mask, that'll be at least 10 liters a minute, not to exceed 15. And then adjust regulator to show, there we go, a flow rate of 10 to 15. And then you'll attach the mask to the patient's face and adjust it to fit snugly. So that's a skill. That's what you're going to be expected to do. This is the equipment. This is the therapeutic regulator. Up here, you can see the dial that shows you the PSI. Full would be 2,000. And we typically switch them out when they drop below 1,000. This is where you will select the flow rate. Typically for nasal cannula, that's going to be anywhere from 1 to 6. And for non-rebreather mask, that's going to be 10 to 15. This is the port where you will connect the tubing of the non-rebreather mask. On the end right here, you just put that. That's called the connector tree. This is the T-handle. This actually tightens down the regulator to the stem of the O2 tank, which is right here. This is a D-tank. This is our portable tank that we carry into the scene with us. This is the cylinder key. This actually, this plastic piece opens up the valve up here that allows you to pressurize the regulator. And this is your non-rebreather mask. That's what you put on the patient's face. Make sure that you guys, you see this little aluminum piece, make sure you actually pinch that down and pull the strap tightly. Now, when we categorize respiratory disturbances, three things we need to be aware of: respiratory distress, respiratory failure, respiratory arrest. Let's define each one. Respiratory distress is adequate, that's tidal volume and respiratory rate, provide supplemental oxygen to maintain SpO2 saturation of greater than 94%. So typically in between the range of 94 to 90%, you're going to use a nasal cannula. Below 90, you use a non-rebreather mask, although there are exceptions to that. That's not a hard and fast rule. Respiratory failure is defined as inadequate tidal volume and or inadequate respiratory rate. Positive pressure ventilate with supplemental oxygen would be how you treat that. It would be inappropriate to provide somebody in respiratory failure with a non-rebreather mask or a nasal cannula. Then we have respiratory arrest. That is absent tidal volume and respiratory rate. Agonal respirations are possible, but those are not organized respirations. Those do not count. And for this, you will treat with positive pressure ventilation attached to oxygen. Oxygen indications, O2 sat, we've talked about this already, 90 to 94 nasal cannula. That's going to be 1 to 6 liters a minute typically. And then less than 90% is when you see a lot of people use a non-rebreather mask, 10 to 15 liters a minute. But these are general guidelines. These are, there are examples where patients with an SpO2 of greater than 90% will be given a non-rebreather mask and vice versa. It all depends on patient presentation and history. This all goes back to your assessment. How thorough did you go through your assessment? Did you ask all the appropriate questions? Did you actually get the patient's history? To administer either a nasal cannula or non-rebreather, the patient must have adequate rate and tidal volume. So that's just really basic oxygen administration by non-rebreather mask. If you guys have any questions, just let me know, and I'll see you guys next time.